95.1.
You need to blacken up a bit.
You're Jack Donaghy.
What happened back there on the way to school?
With me and get her highlights done too, but she don't listen. Yeah. No, yeah, she went to her friend's salon. Now she look like a rainbow.
Where's Barry's apartment?
Girl, let me call you back.
Shout out EmEz and tune in to the sit down.
EmEz does it, do it easy. That's what I'm doing.
It is the sit down, Shemaine, man. EmEz, and across from me is actress. Ah, man, you and this name, man.
His name De'Adre. De'Adre.
De'Adre. There you go. You special black people. De'Adre. Hello, actress, singer. How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Welcome back.
Thank you.
It's been a while since you've been here.
Yeah.
What's changed?
Wait, well, we shot the whole season.
Yes.
The breaks. Last time I was here, I didn't know if I was going to be in it.
Yeah, right.
I'm dead serious.
Yeah, right.
Listen, actors will tell you until we sign that contract and show up and, like, actually start shooting something, we just can't trust it.
De'Adre, don't play with me.
It's true. I had no idea.
I do this.
I had no idea. Then when I signed my contract, they guaranteed me one episode, and I wound up in 7. So, like, that's how it goes.
Okay,
you just don't know.
Janelle, come into the camera, please. Janelle. Hi. This is my assistant, Janelle, ladies and gentlemen. She's been with me so almost all of these interviews. Janelle, how often do actors tell us, oh, I'm doing something new, but I can't tell you?
All the time.
Oh, no, I swear, this is not that. This is not that. No, you can ask my agents. You can call them 212-757-009. Ask for Steve, and he'll tell you that, like, we didn't know if it was going to shoot, and then when I got my contract, they guaranteed me one episode.
Okay, so
dead ass.
Can you talk about this Spike Lee situation you got on now?
Oh, so I did 3 episodes of She's Gotta Have It. So, you know, he turned his...
Are you allowed to talk about
it? ...into a series. I can talk about what I did.
You see, Janelle, you see it, right? You see it, right? Here it comes. Go ahead. Here it comes. All right, so tell me more about She Gotta Have It.
So I play a middle school principal called Rockaletta Moss.
To the guys in the room, excuse me. your teacher ever looked that bad,
guy?
Middle school. Imagine that middle school. Look ahead, as you were. Continue.
I had this shortcut in the business suit and all
right.
That kind of stuff. I play Rockaletta, who was born and raised in Brooklyn, and now working at a middle school with at-risk kids. And so I just have some interaction with the lead character, Nola Darling, who's like hustling on the side for some money and stuff like that. So, yeah.
Okay, all right. Has that premiered yet?
No, that's going to be on Netflix maybe sometime summer, early fall.
Oh, okay.
So, mm-hmm.
Okay. I love the way TV is changing with the whole Netflix and Hulu and stuff. Like, Netflix, it's its own channel, pretty much. They're creating their own content. It's dope.
It's a game changer. And
man.
Amazon
too.
Original movies. They did Spike Lee, Chirac.
Speaking of Amazon, Cuzzo, you remember the Blue City series thing? They picked it up on Amazon.
Wow.
Yeah, over 3 million views.
Blu-ray.
Hopefully I'm coming for that check. Just saying. So sit down, it's your main man, EmEz. De'Adre is in the building. Now talk to me about the breaks.
The breaks, man.
It went from being just a one-off to a whole full-out season show. How do you feel about that?
I love it. It's we're finding that it's hitting an audience that doesn't even really understand the concept of hip-hop just starting in the industry and radio not playing it, you know?
True.
They just kind of don't even understand that actually happened, where, like, you couldn't get hip-hop on the radio. So to do a show that's like, it's not only, you know, about like the hustle here in New York City, but it has that history of the hip hop industry. It's cool for me because I remember it.
I was just about to ask you, can I ask you about your age? Because I don't want to say you look like you might have been from there.
I'll be 40 in June. So there it is.
That's a dope 40.
Thanks.
Dope 40. Well, congratulations. So now, do you actually remember those times?
I do, yeah. I remember when radio stations were kind of like changing their format, and not like there was no announcement. You know, there was no internet back then, mm-hmm. you know, in 1990. So you wake up one day and all of a sudden it's like, oh, you're only going to play freestyle music? You're not going to play this anymore or that anymore? Or I remember those kind of things. And, you know, because there were no internet radio stations and you didn't have that social media power, you just had to go with whatever the radio chose to do and whatever they were kind of feeding you. So I remember that. I remember not being able to hear hip hop, only seeing it on Video Music Box.
Video Music. Shout out to Uncle Ralph.
Yeah, Uncle Ralph. Wow. Daniels. He came by the set, and that was pretty cool.
Do you feel the Breaks is depicting the 90s hip hop the right way?
I do. And Dan Charnas, who wrote the book that the show's based on, he's very particular about making sure that there are things in there that are authentic. Now, because it is a fictitious show, we have, you know, artistic license to stretch certain things, mm-hmm. to do things like based on people
who
really seem like the real people. But, you know, it's still fiction. But, we're trying to keep it as authentic as possible to kind of show people, like, the actual history of what happened.
Dope. It's a sit down. It's your main man, EmEz. De'Adre's in the building, singer, actress. Now, I didn't know you were a Tony Award winner.
I'm not. Are you predicting my future?
Says someone.
Nominee,
excuse me.
It's okay.
So how did you feel about getting nominated for him?
I was surprised by it because I wasn't thinking about any of that. It was my first Broadway show. Mm. And so I didn't know how anything worked. And I knew that nominations were coming out that morning, and I thought maybe our show would get nominated because it was critically acclaimed, but I didn't think I was going to get one. And I just got up, got my son ready for school, took him to the school bus, and went back to sleep, which was the cycle I was in. I was like Cinderella every day, performing on a stage, running home, get as much sleep as possible. So I went back to sleep, and when I woke up, I had a flood of information on my phone, texts and calls, and I was like, what happened? And I was like, I got nominated? It was just weird to me because it wasn't... You know, when you're in mom mode and hustle mode, you're not really thinking about the glory sometimes. You're just thinking about, like, work.
Gotcha.
Putting work in.
Gotcha. And now, how about this sexiest jazz vocalist contest? I didn't even know those type of things go on.
I don't think they do anymore.
Oh, okay.
This was back
when... I was about to say, I want to go to one. I want to see how this goes.
This was back when there was CD 101.9.
Wow!
Remember that?
Wow!
Remember smooth jazz?
Wow!
No, nobody?
Yes.
I'm that old. No.
CBS?
Yeah.
So, they had a contest, and, you know, I think my son was like 3 months old, and I was like, should I go to this? I was so deep in mom mode. Breastfeeding.
What is mom mode? Explain to me mom mode.
Mom mode is when, okay, single mom mode specifically is when you have to take care of this human and you're the only person who's going to get it done. You don't have any help.
I have a little human in my house now.
Yeah.
He tears. I found a quarter in my PlayStation 4 the other night. And I was. And it was whether to throw out my PlayStation or throw out my son. Like, fam, you really like my PlayStation, God. I hope you see this when you're like 16 and you're looking at your whatever system y'all be playing at that age, and I'm gonna mess your shit up too. And you're gonna look like, damn, like, yeah.
But see, and you know though, but as a parent, you gotta do what you gotta do. You throw out the PlayStation, that's what it is.
Oh, no, PlayStation didn't get though. I still have my son though.
Well, there it is. It's all about them, you know what I mean? You gotta do what you gotta do to make sure that their life functions in the way it needs to function. Teach them what they need to learn, feed them, clothe them, and that's the focus. And then, you know, you do the work to have those resources. But even now, my son's almost 16, and, you know, it's primarily like, okay, what does he need? Now we're looking at colleges and all that kind of stuff. So sometimes your personal needs, you know, are second to that, but that's your job as a parent.
That's so refreshing to hear.
Why refreshing?
You know, women that are about the home and son and stuff. You know, I just, you know, I'm not looking at anybody directly about wanting to be. Anyways, let me shut my mouth out here, God. Anyways, it's the Breaks.
Yeah.
My son learned the word fart the other day.
Thought I'd share. It's a great word.
So now every time he farts, he's like, farted. So what's on the horizon for you, De'Adre? De'Adre, excuse me.
Well, I think I've just decided today that I'm going to do Shakespeare in the Park this summer. I got an offer to do that. They're doing the Midsummer Night's Dream. And I'm going to play the Amazon goddess, Hippolyta. So, you know, Theater's
very well cast. Very good cast. Very well casted. I like that. Whoever did that, A plus for you.
You're like, who can we get who's like 6 feet tall? Oh, her. Now, you know, theater's a big commitment. So last summer I did a show with Daniel Radcliffe called Privacy at the Public Theater. And so this summer, this is also the Public Theater. I've been thinking about it, I've decided to actually do it because, you know, it's going to be fun ultimately. It's a commitment, full time.
I mean, I'm assuming it's in the park, it's outside.
And Shakespeare is not easy.
Well, I would like to know when that, how I would support, I would like to go experience the arts.
Yeah, you should come. It's really, like, even if you're not, like, a fan of Shakespeare, it's a nice experience. You're outside in the middle of Central Park at night under the stars.
Can I drink?
Come on. You can sneak a little song.
We black, we gonna figure something out.
Yeah, you want
to. Yeah, a little champagne.
Yeah.
It's the sit down that you made, man. I'm easy. Why'd you become an actress?
I fell in love with it in high school. You know, I was a cornball. I didn't fit in a lot of circles.
You it's notice so how all the pretty true. Girls tell you they were cornballs?
It's so true.
All right, Mike, that's just me, right? Oh, that happens to me.
All the girls that I know tell you they were cornballs. I wore combat boots. I was not cool. I listened to Pearl Jam.
Listen, see, again, like, you grew up in a time frame of kind of real. I grew up. We all were corny. If we look back in those pictures, I was looking back in a picture with the 38 size jeans. My waist was might be like a 22. Jeans were 36. Shirts were like 3XL. Rag. We all look silly.
You know what really makes you corny though, growing up? When you're poor.
Oh no, I didn't say any of my stuff was designer.
When your parents don't have a Lexus and you can't afford the door knockers with your name in it, then they're like, oh,
fam.
You know?
Fam.
Or the guest sneakers.
You talking to the wrong one. God. I had Viking boots. And when I say Viking boots, I don't mean like they look like the Vikings can wear. That was the brand. Viking. Okay.
Wait, so you mean like there was like Timbaland
and Viking? I didn't experience Timbaland until I was in my 18s. Like I was a teenager paying them for myself.
I hear you. So you feel me on the uncool.
Yeah, but you went to but you from Teaneck, God, you got bread.
No, that's not true. That's not true.
See, I have this conversation all the time. Teaneck kids think they grew up rough. What are you talking about?
No, I didn't say I grew up rough. But my mother, like, I could show you where I was from the time that we were 15 after we got kicked out of the house that she couldn't afford anymore. So my mom wanted to stay in Teaneck because she was from the country. She's from Augusta, Georgia.
Got you.
Want to live in the big business city. You know? She heard about this little quiet suburb outside the city. And so we moved there. But we live on the side with the Walgreens. Like, and the train tracks. People know, like, that side of Teaneck. There's the houses, and then
where the Popeyes is.
Yeah, over there.
But that's not rough.
No, it's not rough. But you don't have to have money to live in, like, the apartments in Teaneck. And we did not have money. You can ask the black folk who were in Jack and Jill at my school if we had money. Because they were like, no admittance for you.
Oh, man. So, Teaneck is a weird place to grow up, man.
It was cool. But, you know, I was corny, so I was in the drama club.
So
and
you
that's
were,
where I found my
so you spent a lot of time talking into the mirror.
No, I actually didn't.
No, I find actors always tell me they spend a lot of time talking into mirrors.
I think you're supposed to do that to see like the weird things that your face does. Like, you know, I got this weird like stroke lip thing, whatever. But I don't care about all that. I just focus on the material and the words and whatever. You know, stroke lip.
There was a joke there. I'm not gonna touch it. But there was a joke there. It's the sit down.
That's so dirty.
It's the sit down.
I didn't mean that kind of stroke. I meant like.
I didn't say anything. How you know what I was meaning?
I feel you through the microphone. I know what you're thinking.
Any future roles you're interested in, Miss Danger?
I want to do like a badass, like, you know. Superhero.
I was just about to say, I could see you being like an X-Men, like a Storm.
I want to do that, yeah. Or kind of like that Colombiana when Zoe Saldana was like sliding through. Hey, I'm a little too big to be sliding through stuff. But I could like stomp in the room and like, you know, shoot it up or like.
Have you ever done an action film?
No.
Would you like to?
Yeah.
That seems like they're fun.
Yeah. I've been to the range, I can shoot, so, you know, figure all that out.
It's that Teaneck thing, man. They think they tough. They gotta get a gun.
No!
neck, bow, bow.
You go to the range. Just that's a skill that you need to learn, so that you know.
How good are you? How many times do you actually hit the target?
It depends. With the AK, I'm pretty good.
I don't know if that turned me on or turned me off.
No,
I'm so scared and turned on at the same time.
It's a different look. You know, it's a different look. It's a different feel. And then you got the blowback with certain things. I don't like the big, big, big loud ones. Like, I can't with that. That's too much. But, I mean, what? It's true. It's a skill that you learn as an actor for when you play a cop. Or a badass who comes in the neighborhood and, you know, shoots it up.
I gotta free up some time. I wanna go to a shooting range. I wanna see what this looks like. We gonna figure this out. Me and you, okay. we gonna see what this looks like. A female in a gun range with that big old AK.
Yeah, I mean, they're carrying them now. They're in the army. They're in the army, FBI, CIA, all that. Yeah.
Back to the breaks here.
Yeah.
Do you know if this is going to be another, if there's going to be another season of the breaks?
I really hope so. But we haven't had any official word. I'm not just saying that. Trust me, I'm not. Everybody's right. Waiting to hear about season two. You know, we'll see. I hope so, though, because it's a fun show to do.
What's the weirdest thing that happens on set? Because you're around Wood, Harris, Mac, Wilds. Give me something. Because I got Mac coming up here in a little. I want, give me something. Give me something. She told me you was what?
Okay, I'll give you like a weird scenario that we were involved in. We were shooting down in the East Village by Planned Parenthood, and there were these protesters across the street. Okay. It was these dudes. Some of them were like priests with like, you know, the collar and all that, and they all had signs. They were silently protesting across from Planned Parenthood, and they wouldn't move, so we kind of had to shoot around them, make sure they weren't in the shot, and it was kind of weird. But then, like, a lot of, like, crew members would, like, run up in front of them and, like, take a selfie and stuff, and they wouldn't move. They were just there. But it was, like, you could feel their energy. It was just, like, this tension, and it was crazy, but that's what happens when you shoot in New York.
It sounds like, you ever, I don't know if you've ever been or ever heard of these silent parties. You guys ever hear one of them, like, you go into the club and they just give you headphones. Mm-hmm. Everyone in the club has headphones.
Seriously?
And it's dead quiet.
What? That's so weird.
But
like the headphones that you wear at the range so you don't go deaf?
I've never been.
Those are, yeah.
We can end this now. She's gonna shoot me.
No! It's just a skill.
Oh, did you hear the evil laugh? No doubt. Careful with Miss De'Adre here. Now, any last words you want to tell the fans before you shoot me?
I would just say stay tuned into the breaks. The season gets crazier. It's just some wild stuff happening.
I can't ask you what's going to happen because you're going to tell me, watch the show.
All I'm going to say is Tamika's got the all-seeing eye. And she knows when people walk in the door if they're full of it or not. That's all I'm going to say. We see some stuff revealed, and Tamika's like, I know what I know.
All right. She didn't give us anything. what you got to take, right? Thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
Appreciate you. Seat is always welcome for you whenever you have. And I do want to see what the gun range is like.
Okay.
One day maybe we'll set that up. Get some cameras and see you shoot something.
Let's do
Hopefully not me. It's the sit down. It's De'Adre. It's your main man, EmEz. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Shout out EmEz and tune in to the sit down.
Boy, you should have known by now. EmEz does.
Power 105.1.